kids call me bad names like zebra, cow, monster, and that really hurt me at that time. But now, if I had a choice to cure my skin condition, I wouldn't do it. It's a part of me. Today, I'm having a photo shoot for the very first time with another vitiligo model.
This is my vitiligo brother.
And my vitiligo sister.
My vitiligo first started when I was 5 years old. I got a huge spot around my eye. Me and my mom went to the doctor and the doctor told us that I have vitiligo. It just happened one day, like out of the sudden. It's nothing that we could do about it. We've seen doctors and they gave me a different medication. I had to use the lotions every day, 3 times a day. I was bullied in elementary school. The kids call me all types of bad names like zebra, cow, monster, and that really hurt me at that time because I really was insecure about myself and I'm a very shy person. So every time someone called me cow, it really like, it's like somebody stabs you in the heart. Like I really was so sad and angry all the time. Hey sis. Hello.
Ze kwam best wel vaak boos thuis, verdrietig thuis ook. Omdat mensen dan haar dan weer hadden uitgescholden voor koe. Het maakte mij boos natuurlijk, gefrustreerd ook, want ik kon niet zoveel doen aan haar vlekken natuurlijk.
Rotterdam is zo anders dan Amsterdam. Want hier voel ik me altijd veilig in Rotterdam. Maar zodra ik uit Rotterdam ga om bijvoorbeeld naar een fotoshoot te gaan in Amsterdam of iets, en dan zie je altijd hoe die mensen naar mij staren.
Ja, maar Rotterdam kent jou eigenlijk al, kan je
ja,
zeggen.
Ja, eigenlijk wel.
En heel veel mensen die hebben jou al gezien. Ja. In Amsterdam, als ze jou zien, hebben ze zoiets van... Oh. Dus ik weet niet, dan loop ik met jou en dan zie ik mensen echt naar je staren alsof... Weet ik veel, alsof je een alien bent of zo.
Ja.
Ik kan daar soms zo boos om worden. Omdat ik jou natuurlijk anders ken.
Ja. Maar weet je,
soms zeg ik dan ook gewoon, wat kijk je?
Ja, soms word je echt boos.
At the age of 11, my skin changed. My vitiligo got bigger and bigger on my arms, on my legs, and especially my face. And it turned out beautifully because I had like freckles on my face and stuff like that. But now it's like one structure. I was 15 years old. At that age, you would start going out. One day, I decided to wear a cute top. It's like a top with straps, so no sleeves. I went to the party and I got so many good compliments from people that it really brought a smile to my face. And I thought, oh my God, this is like the best feeling ever I ever felt in my life. So that day I started to dress up more. When I went to college, a friend of mine who has a cousin who is a photographer asked me, would you like to shoot with me one day? When my pictures started to appear online, I got like a lot of good response from people, especially girls. That's when I thought, oh wow. And there were a lot of people with vitiligo themselves asking me for advice, or mothers with children asking me for how should they handle it. So when I saw that positivity, I thought, okay, maybe I should like make this my real job. So that's when I started modeling. Today I'm having a photo shoot for the very first time with another vitiligo model. His name is Farid. It's like, I'm so happy because I have seen people with vitiligo, but I've never done a photo shoot with them. So I'm really excited about it.
I've been a model for over a year about now. And I've never had an assignment with another vitiligo model before. I'm very excited to meet the world today because she's an inspiring, strong woman, also carrying the same skin condition as me. And she is an inspiration for all of us.
I think it's very important to show a very diverse range of models because in society you have so many different types of people, and I love representing all of those so that everyone can see a bit of themselves in the fantasy and they can feel represented. I really love working with Deborah because she's just adorable. She's an absolute sweetheart. And she's absolutely gorgeous, and she knows how to work her features, and she knows that her unique beauty is something that's very special, and so she's not ashamed to show that, and I think that's very important.
This is my vitiligo brother.
And my vitiligo sister.
I'm really happy that I got in the modeling / fashion industry on time, because I know a few years back there wasn't any diversity because every model has to be tall and tiny, small waist and stuff like that. But now they're accepting people like me, people who are plus size or not as tall, or you know, different features, ethnicities and stuff like that. So I really hope that it will stay this way. I'm really happy with the results. I had a great team who was working with me. I was also very excited to work with Farid. The most important message I want to give to everyone else dealing with skin conditions is to love yourself first.